But let's start the show by heading over to the UK, where future King Prince George has celebrated his 10th birthday this weekend. The double-digit landmark for King Charles's grandson was celebrated with the release of a new photo as rumours swirl about his future plans. From London, our UK correspondent Gavin Gray joins us now. Good morning, Gavin. I'm guessing you're not celebrating the cricket, but what celebrations have there been for Prince George?
Yeah, not the only parties taking place in Australia. There have been some here, but no sign of Prince George over the weekend, just that official portrait that we see. My sources are saying they did have a small family gathering, close family and a couple of friends, but certainly we've not seen him out and about. As you say, no celebrations about the cricket, but the photo itself, incidentally, taken at Windsor Castle, and certainly a young man beginning now to grow up, and we see so many comparisons with Prince William and Kate about the eye colour and so forth. But what I love, he's wearing those brown suede shoes again, a favourite of the so-called casual look of Prince William.
Gavin, how is Prince George leaning into public life? I mean, living in the spotlight is never easy, but how's he doing?
Yeah, I think he's pretty good, really. I mean, you know, he must be so used to all the cameras now and the media attention wherever he goes, including even sometimes when they're abroad, you know. So I think he must be getting pretty used to that. But what an amazing 10 years it's been and how quickly it's flown by. And so adapting to it is going to be really, really important. The question that's now coming in, of course, is what next in terms of his next school? And he was spotted last week at Eton College outside Windsor, so it'll be local and convenient for him. And of course, that's where Princes William and Harry went to, not the King Charles, though. He went to a boarding school in Scotland, which he absolutely hated. Mm. I think William and Harry both found Eton okay, quite enjoyed it. And so perhaps we're going to see Prince George go there, but no confirmation of that one yet.
All right, we're all waiting to see what the next steps are for everything. And traditionally, the future king does a stint in the armed forces as well. Will that be the same for Prince George? And at what age does that start?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of question marks over that now, because as you say, traditionally, you know, the royal is always looking for something to do. And of course, he will become ultimately the commander of the armed forces. So that's why they've always been keen to serve a stint. It didn't go particularly well, as we know, for Prince Charles. Prince Andrew loved it, and Prince Edward didn't do and last particularly well either. So it's not for everyone. Prince William did enjoy his time there, as we know, and Harry loved it again. But I think there's a change in emphasis here, and I don't think George is in any way going to be forced to do it. I think they're actually going to give him a far greater say in the next few years of his life than Prince William and certainly King Charles ever had. It's interesting to see the reaction to this 10th birthday landmark, though, and what people say on social media. Now, bear in mind, guys, we're talking about a 10-year-old. Mm. Here are some of the comments doing the UK social media rounds. So somebody has said with the photo, entitled spawn of the UK's most dysfunctional family. Another one said, the chuffed face of perpetual entitlement. This to a 10-year-old boy, I repeat. Another one, pity the dysfunctional family he was born into will destroy any chance of him reaching normality. And lastly, a pretty horrid comment, the horsey, baldy, awkward genes will be kicking in soon. The keyboard warriors, as I said, out in force. I don't know how damaging this is for a 10-year-old, but, you know, we think, well, he won't see those comments. But I dare say some at the school or whatever he goes to may well be repeating them. So although there are lots of nice comments about it, wishing him all the best, there's no doubt the pressure on this young man will be intense.
Mm. Horrendous. Horrendous. Mm.
Gavin, news this morning, though, on a slightly lighter note, that we might get some royals visiting Australia.
I think so, Ange. News is reaching me of a sort of soft diplomacy route, in that since King Charles has been coronated, he's only been for one official trip abroad, and that was to Germany. And apparently there's a bit of tug of war here, because the trips have to be approved, state visits have to be approved by the Foreign Office at a government level. And apparently the royals are really ready. And I don't think Prince Charles, King Charles, is an idiot here, because he's realising that actually some of the most successful trips have been conducted by Prince William and Kate and their children. And so I do think, particularly around the Commonwealth, we are likely to see trips now lined up for them, juggling no doubt family life, trying to keep the children's feet on the ground with these visits, but I do think we can expect to see Prince William, Kate, and at least some of the two of the three children heading abroad, particularly, I think, looking to try and tie the Commonwealth together. Australia, New Zealand, very high up on that list, I'm sure. And these trips, I think, being planned for probably next year, stretching on to the year after that.
Well, it won't be in 2026 anymore, will it, for the Commonwealth Games?
Yeah, for sure.
Too soon.
Yeah. Gav, we've been hearing about a touching moment by a member of the King's Guard. Tell us about that.
Yeah, this is amazing video. The King's Guard, of course, are told, you know, don't move, don't talk to anyone. You're guarding the King, so stand there. And a carer took a young man with Down syndrome to take some photos. And the young man was obviously a bit scared of this guard in uniform. And the guard very kindly saw what was going on and just took one step nearer the young man in order that somebody could take a photo of them together. The carer said he was absolutely astounded. He thanked the guard for moving in, and the young man, you know, was obviously questioning as to why the guard wouldn't speak to him, and the carer said very quietly, he's on duty, he can't speak to you. And now, normally, the guards get into trouble for this, but I think on this occasion, they've been pretty pleased with the fantastic publicity they've had. It's been viewed a lot on social media, as you can imagine, and hopefully, the young man got an experience which so few do. You will remember, there have been experiences where people have got in the way of the guards and they've forcibly been moved aside. In this case, I'm pleased to say some better PR coming out for the King's Guard.
Yeah, that being said, I like seeing those videos when they kind of go straight through people. Gavin, we love when you take a step closer and talking to us. We appreciate you as always. Good on.
Cheers, guys.
Take care.